All right, time to get this underway, it looks like.
Yeah, so this is the first round of the tournament with Hikaru versus... Fupi.
It's all right.
There we go. Okay, so Milia versus Kai, this is basically just... Milia can do things in neutral, and then when she gets into set play, she just goes... pretty much just this with YRC and then into combos from there, and then Kai is going to play more of a neutral game, just waiting for this punish stuff, staying out of range. That was a really interesting secret garden, kind of point blank.
Yeah, he's really putting pressure on.
Stun edge mid screen.
Bobby is fighting back a little bit.
Yeah.
Locked Hikaru in the corner, though. That's a good move for Foppy. Way you can keep it going. Oh.
Kind of back. Oh, gets a knockdown. Close to the corner.
Yeah, he's kind of coming back.
Gets a CL down. Stun edge.
This one's coming down to the wire.
Gets Greed Sever, no combo after it, though. Sweep, disc. Oh, lands a disc, even though the Bad Moon missed.
And Hikaru takes the first one. Doing best 2 out of 3, all right? Gotcha. Yeah, best 2 out of 3. Yeah.
Gets the Secret Garden down, gets a good position for it, and then Air Car gets punished. Greed Sever into...
Ooh, air combos him a little bit there. Man, much faster than I can go on these games.
Gets a knockdown in the corner. Does not get a good disc setup, though. This is 2H.
Ooh, Buffy's actually doing some good on this round.
It's a throw. Does not punish the Secret Garden with there.
Just kind of hiding out in the corner there. Yeah. Oh, but he's bringing back the pressure. He's trying to take the game back.
Oh,
but,
gets the disc super. Both last two discs whiffs, and it's not good.
Yeah, it looks like he's got some runner. Ooh.
Get 6H on that.
Yeah, it looks like Hikaru takes that one again.
All right, so second
first,
game.
First round to Hikaru. Looks like they're sticking with the same characters. Or did one of them swap out?
No, they're
so no, it looks like the same.
Still
okay.
Milia Kai.
Alright.
Gets the 6H overhead on that. Able to get the JH knockdown as well. Nobody's really confirming anything, except that was a small confirm. Gets a knockdown. It's not gonna a very good disc setup on the corner there, just because not able to get the OP off of it.
Keeps getting little hits on him in the corner there.
Yeah, nobody really landing anything.
Basically nicking him to death.
Oh, almost had the knockdown combo there. Gets Greed Sever. Nothing confirmed after it, though. Lands a 6P on that.
Hikaru took that one again. Not looking good for Foppy.
Gets a knockdown. Mm-hmm. Poppy lands a no-hit after that, though.
Just kind of
6-H.
Straight forth there for a little bit. But Hikaru's taking the lead again.
It's not over yet. Goes for the slide there. Doesn't get the second hit of it. Greets ever. Doesn't get the disc combo at the end there.
Doesn't look good for Foppy again. Yep, there he
goes
again.
Combo, and then Hikaru. Yeah, takes that game, so he'll be going on in winners. And then second game is, I have no idea. You really weren't that best, I guess. Some guy named Kai enters Matt.
Some guy named Kai. All right.
Okay, so I have no idea who these two play, though, so.
Characters in Guilty Gear.
Yeah, definitely a lot of
strange ones.
Yeah.
The guy with the bag on his head. What was his name again?
Faust.
Faust. Yeah. I don't know Guilty Gear all that well. I know Street Fighter and Mortal Kombat. Those are the ones I know. But it's nice to see Guilty Gear finally getting into like more of the 3D realm. Because they used to use the 2D sprites for the longest time.
Yeah,
it was like a 2D on a 3D plane kind of thing, and I'm glad they finally switched to this like fully 3D look. It's really nice for it, especially the anime style they've got going.
Yeah, I think it was, what is it? XX was the last version they had, and they updated that for, I think it came out 2001, and then they updated it for 2000 something. I don't know, so don't quote me on that.
Yeah, well, next-gen consoles are definitely making some of those fighting games look pretty good these days.
Yeah.
Slayer.
Both of these.
All right. Looks like we're about ready to get the next match underway.
All right, so Leo versus Slayer. This is actually a matchup in Leo's favor. Both of them. Leo's more on the mid-tier spectrum, and then Slayer's probably either the worst character or second worst character in the game. So, Slayer can... This is a... Exert is kind of a game where anybody can win, though, with good knowledge of...
If you know the characters well enough.
Yeah. Axel might be the worst. I don't know. Axel still has stuff. I think Axel's, like, third worst, but other than that... Alright, so match starts. Leo gets into stance from that, able to get some pressure going. It just goes for the counter at Sagger there. Not Sagger, but ground pound.
Leo got a nice start to the match for sure.
Yeah.
Slayer's gonna have to play catch up for the rest of that.
Yeah, Slayer can do a lot of damage off of counter hit combos, so if he can land a good counter hit pile bunker or mop a punch. Just going for the Leo pressure there.
Oh,
going for chip.
Leo might have it. Ah, Leo got it.
Yeah, must have let go of guard on the last one.
That was tough. He put a lot of pressure on him for that whole match.
Yeah. Once Leo gets started into pressure with his stance and stuff,
it's hard to make him stop.
Yeah. Usually bursting out of his pressure will reset it since he doesn't have that good of a neutral game, so he can't. He has issues just making that happen.
Ooh. You got some good hits on
that. Oh, goes for the instant kill? That's kind of wild. Does not get it. Oh, got a counter hit too. That could have been decent damage off that. Oh, that's going to be counter hit dead on time.
Ooh.
Oh, not counter hit dead on time? I guess it's just Hellfire. That was interesting.
Very close. Throwing some projectiles. Oh!
Okay, so first one goes to Kai there. switched to Sol, actually, so Sol has pretty good neutral and some pretty good pressure, not really good mix-up on anything, just more...
Maybe there to counteract Leo's pressure a little bit.
Yeah, with his DP, he can get out of certain gaps.
Looks like Sol got a nice little start there. He's definitely doing a lot better with Sol than he did with the other character last
Slayer.
Match. Slayer Mask, I'll say. So yeah, I'm still learning the names on Guilty Gear. Alright.
Both of them kind of just trading, not really getting...
Yeah, Leo just got a good hit there, though.
Oh, goes into Dragon Install, so this is comeback mechanic for Sol if he can get a good combo from it.
Sol seems to be getting his combos off.
Ooh, got just a regular throw. Gets out of Dragon Install, so we'll lose on that meter.
Kai's going to have to be cautious in this.
Leo going in for pressure. Leo still has his burst, but oh, doesn't punish the DP after that.
Looks like Kai got. Oh no, looks like Drizmat that time.
Oh wow.
Just barely pulled that out. It's a pretty close one. Maybe Drizmat can actually win back a match here and tie it up with Sol.
Possibly. Oh, gets a counter hit. No combo after that, though.
Yeah, it seems like Drizmat's doing a lot better with Sol than he was doing with Slayer.
Yeah.
Seems to match up with Leo much better.
Ooh, gets a stance parry on that.
Yeah, it's locked in the corner.
Gets dust. Not really a good combo on that. That could have killed.
That's on the defense. Oh, and Kai took it. So it's tied up for this round.
Oh, no, that's Leo. Kai was the other one guy.
Are we swapped here? I thought Kai was...
No, that's Sol on the right and then Leo on the left. It's kind of no good combo into that, though. Nobody's really confirming anything yet. Goes in stance super, but this is not taking any chip damage from it. Since, oh, in stagger.
Oh, and he missed. Got him from behind.
Dragon install, will he punish? Oh, he gets a hit. Gets the, oh.
Oh, and
that's game.
There it is.
All right, so some
Kai
guy
took
Dragon.
The round.
So that was 2-0 for Kai, and then. Are we doing my game next, or is it? Okay. Yeah, since they're just buys.
Arrogant bastard! How dare anyone have your feet?
Okay.
Switching out commentators. So is that it for the winning bracket so far? Are we into the loser bracket now, or? Oh no, we're doing round two of winner bracket. Okay.
Yeah.
Got the buys in. Okay.
We could have done you and Kai first, also. Do you want to clear out the buys in the loser rounds?
Interesting way you guys take care of the buys and challenge. I used to just let it take care of it, but you guys actually enter a person for the buy on every.
Yep.
Nice. Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, they factor for it, but it does look weird. Like, they always put their buys into, like, they make it go into the second round and stuff. So, yeah, I like the way you guys are doing it there. I might start using that more often.
All right. Starts off, you know.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Started off strong.
Yeah. And the air combos there. The thing with Potemkin is once he gets started, he's a heavy hitter, but Eno's really fast.
He's hard to get started on a fast character like that.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah, I can see him having issues with that. Just trying to get his combos off.
Great with his combos there. Keeping the pressure on, like Jesus.
Yeah. Much of a chance there.
Yeah. See, and the nice thing about that note from the ground there is it forces him into a block state so he can push himself forward.
Pretty quick round win.
Yeah. Havoc takes first round.
Character switches here, probably. It looks like
Faust. Okay.
Havoc sticking with his same character.
He's a shenanigans character.
Faust. He looks interesting with the bag over his head.
Yeah, he's very shenanigans.
Reminds me of Voldo from Soul Calibur.
Pretty fair comparison.
In that way, you know, he's just a weird character.
He's an insane doctor who does all sorts of random things.
Yeah,
he'll throw stuff that'll damage himself.
And he licks the enemy? That's awesome. I already like him already.
Yeah. See,
nice.
The hit him with the dust to start off with a baseball bat swing, but no follow-up. But, I mean, already this round, he's already done much more damage to Havoc just with Faust as it is.
Yeah, he got in a lot more hits this way. But it just seems like
Havoc's got him in the corner now.
It's too good with that character. What is that one? T-N-O?
No, I know.
I know. Okay.
Keep the juggles. Don't let him touch the ground. No, nope, you don't get... Oh.
No ground for you.
I didn't say you could sit down.
It's just punishing.
He is.
That I know. It's just a punishing character, it seems like. Sending some projectiles.
Yep. Will just really wants to land that baseball bat. 2-0 Havoc. All right. Should we have Kai and Matt hop on? Yeah. You and Matt.
Oh, you're out.
See you, Mark. All right.
Another match underway here soon.
Yep. Let's get into semifinals, then we'll go into loser's round, and from there it'll go into loser's finals, and then...
Yeah.
So he makes top.
We'll see who takes victory.
Who takes home the gold?
That's them setting up their like controller setups.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just changing it to skin.
That's cool. I've never seen a fighting game like give you the controller setup right in the character selection.
Street Fighter. Yeah, a lot of them do it. Street Fighter lets you do it. Pretty much every Arc System Works game lets you.
I'm just not a kind of person to change the controller scheme. I guess. I usually just stick with the defaults and kind of go with it and learn it from there. I feel like if I learn a different different set and I try and play at someone else's house or something and it's set to default, I'm just going to lose. So I just try and learn default.
I think the only company that doesn't really do it well is SNK. And Mortal Kombat, you have to be in-game, also change controls, so... Is it? It's good to see fighting games go more and more to the character select change controls.
makes more sense.
Oh, yeah. But, I mean, Arc System Works is, like, the leading company in that. Like, they would... Yeah.
Leo's got some good hits on already.
He does. Nope. Now he's going in with just the continued... Oh, he was going with the loop. Spin loops, but... That white thing, there it goes.
For that long combo. There it is. Kai seems to be doing pretty good with that Leo.
Leo is really, really good. Something that's kind of really cool, I don't know if you pay attention to the stage, but if you take a look at the background on the monitor
screen of the fight, that's cool.
And it'll give you stats for each character up there. So that, I mean, that's like small stuff that's really neat that they throw into the games.
Yeah, visually this game is just beautiful. Like,
yeah, and even in the screen, there's a smaller screen, so supposedly like constantly.
Never ending,
yeah, constantly.
It's got the mirror effect, which is never ending.
You know, it takes up 60% of the processing power of the PS4 just for one stage, but
hey,
we'll take it.
If it looks pretty, why not? Because, you know, fighting games are all about prettiness.
They are.
Oh, man.
Oh,
Leo gonna take it again.
Kai takes it. He just wants to read you a bedtime story, that's all. See? Look. It's a nice little bedtime story.
About forbidden magic?
Forbidden magic.
You know, the kind of story you'd read to your 8-year-old.
Maybe Sodom and Gomorrah.
Oh, we're doing a rematch, same characters.
Takeda has a dive kick.
Carter's starting out with some good pressure.
He is. Well, I mean, yeah, he needs to keep it up. Because once, like, heavy hitters like that, once it gets going,
you can't stop them.
Yeah. And Millie is a really light character, so. Up. There we go. Nice.
Air counter?
Yep. Leo getting
in. Hikaru doesn't get trapped in the corner. He can have this.
Yep. Up.
Leo's coming
back.
Oh. Kai took it back.
No salt for him today.
Oh, bringing him his
chair. He needs, he needs the throne.
Needs to sit and relax for a minute. I like the little robot assistant. Or is that just like a dude in a giant
suit?
That's
a dude in a giant suit.
Oh, so it's an actual guy. Like,
yeah.
Here, master, let me bring you your chair.
It's like Potemkin, essentially.
It's like a squire or something like that.
Yeah. I mean, he is a king, so.
That makes sense.
Hikaru in a very bad spot right now.
Yeah, he's going to have to really work for this one.
There it is. Is that an instant? Did he instant killed you? That instant kills are kind of like an insult.
Destroyed.
Yeah, add on.
Yeah.
So.
Is it a long combo you have to do to get?
No, it's pretty much, you know, when someone's going to instant kill because they go into the stance and you just let the meter run out. Mm. Like, if you let yourself get hit. I mean, we're going to go into losers now because all that's left in winners finals is two people.
You want to commentate for losers?
So, losers.
No.
I'm all alone and commentating again.
Yes. Kai, you want to hop on? Come on, you just
Fine, I'll just commentate by myself. Do I smell or something? No, it's okay. I understand if I smell. It's alright.